السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is our fifth lesson going through the revision of Medina Arabic book number one. We have arrived at lesson number five, and this lesson, the main topic that's going to be discussed is the mudaf ilayh, the possessive relationship that can occur between two nouns. So, مثلا, if I want to denote that this book belongs to Muhammad or this phone belongs to Muhammad, and I want to say this is Muhammad's book or this is the book of Muhammad, then this relationship in Arabic is called the mudaf ilayh, where the mudaf is the one that is possessed, or the thing that is possessed, in this case the book, and the one doing, or the one taking possession of the book, or the one who is the possessor, is the mudaf ilayh. So مثلا, in the sentence when he says أَكِتَابُ مُحَمَّدٍ هَذَا يَا يَاسِرُ, is this the book of Muhammad, or is this Muhammad's book, أو يَاسِر, of course, yeah, he's the vocative particle. And yasir originally is yasirun. When there's a vocative particle in front of it, the tanween converts to one dhamma, so it becomes ya yasiru. Right? Good. Akitabu Muhammadin. Kitabu here is the mudaf. Muhammadin is the mudaf ilayh. The mudaf ilayh can't be mansub and it can't be marfu'. It must always be majrur. It's always in the genitive case. And the mudaf ilayh can sometimes be a nakira and it can sometimes be a ma'rifah. The mudaf ilayh can sometimes be a nakira and it can sometimes be a ma'rifah. Therefore, it can sometimes have a tanween, and sometimes it can have al. Right? Kitabu al-imami. Kitabu Muhammadi. That's in the mudaf ilayh. However, the mudaf in and of itself, it's a ma'rifah. And so since it's a ma'rifah, it doesn't need al. So you won't have al in front of it. So you don't say al-kitabu Muhammadi. Because kitabu in and of itself, in this case, because it's a mudaf, the mudaf is always a ma'rifah. Likewise, since it's a ma'rifah, you can't accept tanween. Tanween doesn't enter upon ma'rifah. Right? And so we say that it won't take the tanween and it won't take al. Okay? Generally speaking, it won't take tanween and it won't take al. So, مثلا, you say what? مكتب المدرسي. You don't say المكتب المدرسي. You don't say مكتب المدرسي. لا, you say مكتب المدرسي. مكتب المدرسي. كتاب عمرين كتاب زيدين قلم من من هي مضاف إليه but it's مبني. So when he says مثلا قلم من هذا, من here is a مضاف إليه, قلم is a مضاف, whose book, right? But من here is مبني, it's indeclinable. طيب, so there is no change to indicate its function, it's indeclinable, مبني. As I mentioned, the مضاف, it is capable of being مرفوع, it is capable of being منصوب, it is capable of being مجرور. مثلا مكتب المدرسي, مكتبه is مرفوع, إن مكتب المدرسي منصوب, على مكتب المدرسي, right? It is what? In the مجرور case for the مضاف, but the مضاف إليه is always مجرور. كتاب القارئ, right? مكتب المدرسي, على مكتب المدرسي. In all cases, the مضاف إليه is always what? It is always مجرور. And as I mentioned, the مضاف إليه can sometimes be a نكرة and it can sometimes be معرفة. Right? مثلا كتاب طالب, كتاب طالب, the book, يعني the book of a student. Here it's a نكرة. كتاب الطالب, here it's a معرفة. The مضاف, مضاف, the مضاف إليه. However, the مضاف is always a معرفة. It can't be a نكرة. طيب. And as I mentioned, the مضاف can't have تنوين. And it can't have أل. It can't be منصوب. And it can't be مرفوع. And as you mentioned also, that مثلا من قلم من هذا أو تحت المكتب, تحت here is a مضاف. من إن قلم من is a مضاف إليه. But in the case of من, even though it is مضاف إليه, there is no كسرة on its ending, unlike مكتب المدرسي. Why? Because it's مبني, مبني على السكون. طيب. Sometimes you can have, like, if you continue here, so this is just يعني easy exercises. مثلا أين كتاب محمد, you see what, هو على المكتب, right? طيب, أين كتاب محمد, كتاب محمد, right? Where is the book of Muhammad? Here is the mudaf, mudaf. You can answer it by saying what? هو على المكتبي. Right? نعم. Again here in the second example, in the second exercise, he's telling you to rewrite the second word, or rewrite the two words in each of these groups so that the second word is in the possessive form. For example, مفتاح البيت قلم حامد بيت عباس غرفة علي دفتر سعيد منديل ياسر قميص عمار سرير خالد مفتاح السيارة بنت الطبيب كتاب الله اسم الولد بيت المهندس. Of course, اسم here, right? The همزة is همزة وصلة, right? اسم الولد جمال واسم البنت. So حال الوصل it's dropped وحال الابتداء it's what I found. Yeah. Again here you're continuing to read so you can understand the principle. باب المدرسة تي حمار الرجل بيت حامد سيارة المدير منديل عمار اسم الطالب بيت الله في كتاب الله من بيت المدرس على مكتب المدير. Again you're trying to know how to read these words in order for you to be able to figure out where is the mudaf, where is the mudaf ilayh. Maktab is the mudaf, al-mudir is the mudaf ilayh. Maktab is majroor, why? Because it's being preceded by ala. Na'am. Min bayti, bayti here is a mudaf, but it's preceded by min, so it's what? Majroor. Likewise, al-mudirris is majroor, why? Because it's a mudaf ilayh. Baytullahi, mudaf, mudaf ilayh. Fi kitabillahi, kitabillahi here, kitab is a mudaf, Allah is a mudaf ilayh. And you can also repeat it in exercise number 4 where you're reading ابن عمار طالب وابن ياسر تاجر بيت المدرس بعيد وبيت التاجر قريب هذا مفتاح السيارة أين مفتاح البيت من أنت يا ولد أنا ابن عباس أنا ابن عباس ابن here is a مضاف عباس is a مضاف إليه. And again you can see the usage of the pronouns which is connecting the previous lessons of what we have learned there into this lesson as well. See, أنا here is the pronoun that indicate ضمير منفصل that indicates I. Again, here also another point. Ibn oh, أين مسجد رسول الله. مسجد رسول الله. مسجد is a مضاف. رسول is a مضاف إليه. رسول is also a مضاف. Allah is a مضاف إليه. So here you have, in the case, you have what? Two sets of مضاف مضاف إليه. Right? So you have مسجد رسول. Or مسجد رسول الله. مسجد is a مضاف. رسول is a مضاف إليه. رسول is a مضاف. Allah is a مضاف إليه. Yeah, the prophets, the prophet of Allah's mosque. Right, the prophet of Allah, Allah's prophet's mosque. You see, yeah, nah. And again, you can see it in other examples as well. خال حامد فقير, paternal uncle, the maternal uncle. خال is the maternal uncle, your mother's brother. خال حامد فقير, yeah, nah. And you can see it for the remaining, examples. بنت حامد في المدرسة وبنت محمد في الجامعة. عم الطالب غني. اسم المدرس سعيد واسم المهندس خالد, yeah, nah. And in the example on exercise number 5, he's telling you to fill in the blanks and make complete sentences. مثلا أين مفتاح السيارة, right? مثلا خديجة أخت حامد, مثلا القرآن كتاب الله, right? أنا ابن المدرس, right? قلم الطالب مكسور, خارج المدرس من غرفة المدير, مثلا, right? باب البيت مفتوح, باب الجدار, باب البيت مفتوح, رسول الله محمد رسول الله إلى آخره. باب البيت مغلق. Again here in exercise number 6 is telling you to fix the sentence. القلم الطالب, هذا خطأ, يسي قلم الطالب. بنت حامد, يسي بنت حامد. اسم الولد, يسي اسم الولدي, correct it. باب السيارة, correct that by saying باب السيارة. الرسول الله, correct that by saying رسول الله. ابن المدرس, convert it by saying ابن المدرس. And then he's pointing out the vocative particle point, Muhammadun, when you want to make that the vocative, when you want to make that the munada, the one whom you're going to call upon, you don't say Muhammadun, you don't say Ya Muhammadun, you say Ya Muhammadu. You don't say Ya Ustadun, you say Ya Ustadu. You don't say Ya Khalidun, you say Ya Khalidu. You don't say Ya Waladun, you say Ya Waladu. Ya Ariyu, Ya Abbasu, Ya Shaykhu, Ya Rajulu, Ya Yasiru, Ya Ammar, Ya Doktoru, إلى آخره. Kitabu man hada, man is a mudaf ilayh. Kitabu is a mudaf, but man here is indeclinable, mabni. And so you can't see the kasra on it. Why? Because it's a mabni. Yeah, but it is what? مضاف إليه. مثلا كتاب من هذا, you say هذا كتاب زيد, هذا قلم عاصم, هذا مفتاح عمري, right? And of course in terms of the ساعة, هذه ساعة محمد. Yeah. Again here اسم, we mentioned it, اسم ابن, yeah, terms that begin with همزة وصل. So you say اسم الولد محمد واسم البنت زينب اسم المدرس حامد ما اسم المدير ابن خالد في المدرسة وابن حامد في الجامعة ابن المدرس في الفصل أين ابن المدير أين ابن المدير. Yeah, nah. So you can read the sentences incorporating the ruling of Hamzat Wasl. Ibn Muhammad in Iraqi, wa Ibn Hamid in Hindi. Ila akhirih. Ibn man han, Ibn man anta, ana Ibn al-Wazir. Anta here meaning you, second person. So again, here you have the three types of the pronouns: Dhamair Munfasila, the Ghaib, the Mukhatab, and the Mutakallim. Ana and Nahnu is the Mutakallim. Anta, Anti, Antuma, Antum, Antunna is for the Mukhatab. Huwa, Hiya, Huma, Hum, and Hunna is for the Ghaib. And so the main point in the session is what? The Mudaf, Mudaf Ilayh construct. Right? The Mudaf, Sayyaratu, Mudaf Ilayh, Al Mudarrisi. And we've learned some new terminologies as well, which you can put in your notebook. And so these are the main points to remember in this lesson. Tahta means under, right? And so the noun that follows it will become mudaf ilayh, and it will be a mudaf, right? Tahta al-maktabi, tahta al-sayyarati ila akhirih. And we mentioned the concept pertaining to ya. We mentioned these points in the lesson. Hada wallahu a'lam, wa sabhi bi'inillah, subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik, shadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.